Wednesday, 25th May, 2022. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in His presence to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at His hands, to declare His most worthy praise, to hear His holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands prepare the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, it is a people that err in their hearts, for they have not known my ways, of whom I swore in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. Alleluia! The Lord has risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. Teach me, O Lord, the way of your statutes, and I shall keep it to the end. Give me understanding, and I shall keep your law. Indeed, I shall keep it with my whole heart. Make me go in the path of your commandments, for therein is my desire. Incline my heart to your testimonies, and not to covetous desires. O turn away my eyes, lest they behold vanity, and revive me in your ways. Confirm your word to your servant, and to all those who fear you. Take away the reproach that I am afraid of, for your judgments are good. Behold, my delight is in your precepts, O revive me in your righteousness. Let your loving mercy come to me, O Lord, even your salvation, according to your word. So shall I answer those who taught me, for my trust is in your word. O, do not take the word of your truth utterly out of my mouth, for my hope is in your judgments. So shall I keep your law, even forever and ever. So shall I always keep your law, even forever and ever, and I will walk at liberty, for I seek your commandments. I will speak of your testimonies also, even before kings, and will not be ashamed. And my delight shall be in your commandments, which I have loved exceedingly. My hands also will I lift up to your commandments, and I will meditate, on your statutes. O, remember your word to your servant, in which you have caused me to put my trust. This is my comfort in my trouble, for your word has given me life. The proud have held me exceedingly in derision, yet I have not turned aside from your law. For I have remembered, O Lord, your judgments from of old, and by them I have received comfort. I am filled with indignation because of the ungodly who forsake your law. Your statutes have been my songs in the house of my pilgrimage. I have thought upon your name, O Lord, in the night season, and I have kept your law. This has been my reward, because I have kept your commandments. You are my portion, O Lord. I have promised to keep your law. I made my humble petition in your presence with my whole heart. O, be merciful to me according to your word. I have called my ways to remembrance and turned my heart, my feet to your testimonies. I made haste and did not delay to keep your commandments. The courts of the ungodly have encircled me, but I have not forgotten your law. At midnight I will rise to give thanks to you because of your righteous judgments. I am a companion of all those who fear you and keep your commandments. The earth, O Lord, is full of your mercy. O, teach me your statutes. O Lord, you have dealt graciously with your servant according to your word. Teach me true understanding and knowledge, for I have believed your commandments. Before I was afflicted, I went astray, but now I keep your word. You are good and gracious. O, teach me your statutes. The proud have slandered me with lies, but I will keep your commandments with my whole heart. Their heart has become gross with fatness, but my delight is in your law. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I may learn your statutes. The law of your mouth is dearer to me than thousands in gold and silver. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, beginning with the 26th chapter, the first verse. When you come into the land that the Lord your God is giving you for an inheritance, and have taken possession of it and live in it, you shall take some of the first of all the fruit of the ground which you harvest from your land that the Lord your God is giving you, and you shall put it in a basket, and you shall go to the place that the Lord your God will choose to make his name to dwell there. And you shall go to the priest who is in office at that time and say to him, I declare today to the Lord your God that I have come into the land that the Lord swore to our fathers to give us. Then the priest shall take the basket from your hand and set it down before the altar of the Lord your God. And you shall make response before the Lord your God. A wandering Aramean was my father, and he went down into Egypt and sojourned there, few in number, and there he became a nation great, mighty, and populous. And the Egyptians treated us harshly and humiliated us and laid on us hard labor. Then we cried to the Lord, the God of our fathers, and the Lord heard our voice and saw our affliction, our toil, and our oppression. And the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand and outstretched arm, with great deeds of terror, with signs and wonders. And he brought us into this place and gave us this land, a land flowing with milk and honey. And behold, now I bring the first of the fruit of the ground which you, O Lord, have given me, and you shall set it down before the Lord your God and worship before the Lord your God, and you shall rejoice in all the good that the Lord your God has given to you and to your house, you and the Levite and the sojourner who is among you. When you have finished paying all the tithe of your produce in the third year, which is the year of tithing, give it to the Levite, the sojourner, the fatherless, and the widow, so that they may eat within your towns and be filled. Then you shall say before the Lord your God, I have removed the sacred portion out of my house, and moreover, I have given it to the Levite, the sojourner, the fatherless, and the widow, according to all your commandment that you have commanded me. I have not transgressed any of your commandments, nor have I forgotten them. I have not eaten of the tithe while I was mourning, or removed any of it while I was unclean, or offered any of it to the dead. I have obeyed the voice of the Lord my God. I have done according to all that you have commanded me. Look down from your holy habitation from heaven and bless your people Israel and the ground that you have given us, as you swore to our fathers, a land flowing with milk and honey. This day, the Lord your God commands you to do these statutes and rules. You shall therefore be careful to do them with all your heart and with all your soul. You have declared today that the Lord is your God, and that you will walk in his ways and keep his statutes and his commandments and his rules and will obey his voice. And the Lord has declared today that you are a people for his treasured possession, as he has promised you, and that you are keeping all his commandments, and that he will keep and that he will set you in praise and in fame and in honor high above all nations that he has made, and that you shall be a people holy to the Lord your God, as he promised. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We praise you, O God. We acclaim you as Lord. All creation worships you, the Father everlasting. To you, all angels, all the powers of heaven, the cherubim and seraphim, sing in endless praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. Throughout the world, the Holy Church acclaims you. Father of majesty unbounded, your true and only Son, worthy of all praise, and the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide, you, Christ, are the King of glory, the eternal Son of the Father. When you took our flesh to set us free, you humbly chose the virgin's womb. You overcame the sting of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. You are seated at God's right hand in glory. We believe that you will come to be our judge. Come then, Lord, and help your people, bought with the price of your own blood. And bring us to your saints, and bring us with your saints to glory everlasting. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Give, govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day we bless you, we praise your name forever. Keep us today, Lord, from all sin, and have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we have put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope. Let us never be put to shame. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, beginning with the 13th chapter, the 10th verse. Now he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath, and behold, there was a woman who had had a disabling spirit for 18 years. She was bent over and could not fully straighten herself. When Jesus saw her, he called her over and said to her, "Woman, you are freed from your disability." And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight, and she glorified God. But the ruler of the synagogue, the indignant because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath, said to the people, "There are 6 days in which work ought to be done. Come on those days and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day." Then the Lord answered him, "You hypocrites, does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his donkey from the manger and lead it away to water it? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day?" As he said these things, all his adversaries were put to shame, and all the people rejoiced at all the glorious things that were done by him. He said, therefore, "What is the kingdom of God like, and to what shall I compare it? It is like a grain of mustard seed that a man took and sowed in his garden, and it grew and became a tree, and the birds of the air made nests in its branches." And again he said, "To what shall I compare the kingdom of God? It is like leaven that a woman took and hid in 3 measures of flour until it was all leavened." He went on his way through towns and villages, teaching and journeying towards Jerusalem. And someone said to him, "Lord, will those who are saved be few?" And he said to them, "Strive to enter through the narrow door, for many, I tell you, will seek to enter and will not be able. When once the master of the house has risen and shut the door, and you begin to stand outside to knock at the door, saying, 'Lord, open to us,' then he will answer you, 'I do not know where you come from.' Then you will begin to say, And you will begin to say, 'We ate and drank in your presence, and you taught in our streets.' But he will say, 'I tell you, I do not know where you come from. Depart from me, all you workers of evil.' In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, when you see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, but you yourselves cast out. And people will come from east and west, and from north and south, and recline at table in the kingdom of God. And behold, some are last who will be first, and some are first who will be last." At that very hour, some Pharisees came and said to him, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." And he said to them, "Go and tell that fox, 'Behold, I cast out demons and perform cures today and tomorrow, and the third day I finish my course. Nevertheless, I must go on my way today and tomorrow and the day following, for it cannot be that a prophet should perish away from Jerusalem.'" O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it, how often would I have gathered your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you were not willing. Behold, your house is forsaken, and I tell you, you will not see me until you say, Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies and from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of his salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, Lord of heaven and earth, we humbly pray that your gracious providence may give and preserve to our use the harvests of the land and of the seas, and may prosper all who labor to gather them, that we who are constantly receiving good things from your hand may always give you thanks, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, you have brought us safely to the beginning of this day. Defend us by your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin or run into any danger, and that, guided by your Spirit, we may do what is righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the Father, Creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, Sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred and malice, and from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire and flood, from plague, pestilence and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy and rebellion, from violence, battle and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us by the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting and temptation. Good Lord, deliver us by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial. Good Lord, deliver us by your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory. Good Lord, deliver us in all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment. Good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who served their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Almighty God, who in your wrath sent a plague upon your own people in the wilderness for their obstinate rebellion against Moses and Aaron, and also in the time of King David sent a plague of pestilence which killed 70,000, but remembering your mercy spared the rest, have pity upon us miserable sinners who now are visited with great sickness and mortality. And in the same way that you then accepted an atonement and commanded the destroying angel to cease from punishing, so it may now please you to withdraw from us this plague and grievous sickness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and immortal God, giver of life and health, we implore your mercy for your servants who are sickened by this virus, that by your blessing upon them and upon those who minister to them with your healing gifts, they may be restored to health of body and mind according to your gracious will, and may give thanks to you in your holy church, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.